Hey GH peeps, welcome back to my channel where we talk all things General Hospital. Today's late night review is for Tuesday, guys. It is Taco Tuesday. No, Taweri did not have her tacos, but I did have me some pizza, and it was the cauliflower crust. That was banging. I'm gonna start getting pizza with cauliflower crust. That's all I'm gonna say about that. But anyway, peeps, it is April 23rd, 2024. So I hope you guys had a good Tuesday. I had a pretty amazing Tuesday. I cannot not complain. I spent some time with the family, with my son, and went to the nursery. So I was really happy. You know what I'm saying? How was GHing for you guys? I know. It was a bachelorette party. And a bachelor party. I know, guys. I know. Okay? But there were some juicy little, you know, tidbits. You know, Jocelyn and Christina's are... you know, and Tracy getting it down. You know, she was shaking it up. I was like, oh, girl. Okay, Tracy. And Spinelli feeling himself, you know, raving it out. I was like, okay. You know, there were some highlights. There were some high moments. We're going to talk about it. But please leave your highlights in the comment section. And I will, of course, be reposting another video to address comments for yesterday's show. Because you guys said you liked it. And I liked it, too. So whenever I can, I'm definitely going to be doing that. Please like and subscribe if you haven't already. And let's just talk about it, guys. Let's talk about it. Oh, yeah. Somebody said people... I didn't mention Crimson. I'm glad somebody pointed it out. That's going to be a separate video because, yeah, I got to say that by itself. So, guys, we get a new set. Frank, okay, that's good. Okay, Frank. That's what I'm talking about. Frank is kicking ass on that budget, y'all. We got Jason. We got a Maxi back. I mean, Maximista. I mean, that's our Maximista right now, honey. She looking good, honey. And we got a new set, honey. New set. The Port Charles Surf Lodge. I was like, okay. And this is on Stella Place. I mean, I'm sorry, Stella. I'm Stella if you're nasty. Or would I be Stella if you're nasty? I don't know. I just went to my Janet Jackson thing. But anyway, this is Aunt Stella's spot. And she's, you know, invited Trina and Joss. And, you know, Trina's like surprised, you know. She's like, Auntie, I didn't know this was your, you know, your kind of spiggity. And she like, girl, it's Stella, baby. I got a reputation to keep. I was like, okay. See, that's the auntie I'm gonna be like. That's gonna be me. Yeah, it will. Anyway, Josh shows up and tells him about, you know, what's going on with Brooklyn, that there's free food, open bar, and they can always head over there too. I thought that was kind of weird. I would have been like, after we eat here and chill here, if we want to do a part two, we can always head over to Brooklyn's and them and see what they're talking about too. That would have probably been how I would have played it, but they're young, who knows? But Aunt Stella, being the Aunt Stella that she is, and want her Trina to get out because Trina's been just cooped up with her family's like, I'm going to give this table away. But she don't leave, though. So I guess, I don't know. Maybe Aunt Daddy going to meet her there? Guys, I don't know. But she gives the table away, but she stays. And the girls head off to the party. We going to talk about Chase's bachelorette party first. Highlight of this party was the ultimate shade that Dex was getting throughout this party. Like, bro, this is, gosh, y'all seen it? Y'all seen the shade? This worse than Pine Barrens. He got no love. No love at all. Okay, but let's talk about it. So Curtis got his throwing arm good. He's, you know, he's hitting bullseyes. I'm thinking, well, you know, all that willing, pushing yourself in the wheelchair all this time must have made, you know, up your upper body strength. Plus his PT, you know, he's been working. But Drew's impressed. And And Curtis tells him that, you know, it requires finesse to have this type of talent. And Drew's like, hey, well, you know, I went to God and I got like doubles up on, you know, some finesse. So I'm gonna pop my car. Thump. Of course, he don't, you know, even come close to the bullseye. And Curtis is like, well, I guess she should have went a third time. And I was like, oops, okay. And of course, baby, Ned is back. I love me some Natalie. Hey, Natalie. Natalie is back, guys. Ned Quatermain. And he can't help but take a little jab at Drew. Talking about he gonna knock down the whole building. Quatermain, you know, Quatermain humor. At least that's what Drew calls it. And Michael's like, hey, no fighting. At least not yet. We gotta wait for the wedding to happen. We got that has to have that it has to happen during the actual wedding. And this is making me wonder. I hope they do not. Oh, I hope they do not arrest Sunny during Brooklyn's wedding. Can we just have a wedding, please? Can we just have a wedding, please? Anyway, Jordan and Curtis catch up. Cringe. She congrats him about his walking, his miracle feats and his legs, and he gives thanks to his family for his support, and he congrats her on her pending, you know, grandchild, and she's like, I just can't wait, so excited. Meanwhile, Dante wants off desk duty already, so thankfully he's on desk duty, even though I still think he should be at home resting, because the man was, you know, nearly gone. And Anna's like, yeah, for a man who almost died. What's the PT guy say? I think we can wait on that. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, he should be at home. What are we talking about? And Chase teases him about being behind the desk. And Chocolate, Bennett's there, y'all. And he's like, you know, man, we got you covered. We got you covered. And Anna says something about everyone can be a cop and it's an honorable position and all this such and such. And this is as she's talking about it. That's when Dex walk in and the room's like, hiss. Like you hear the male, hiss. I was like, damn, you just walked into a den of we don't fuck with you, okay? But I highlighted because this thing caught me off one, okay? So we got Anna, we got Chase, we got Chocolate Bennett, and we got Dante Fineass. You know what I'm saying? And she's talking about, you know, cops and stuff. And then she says this, and I had to highlight it because I was like, I guess this was an editing problem, or maybe she don't think Chocolate Bennett's worth his salt. But she's like, something about both of you. You know, when she mentioned something about being good cops and how they're so happy to have, she's like, I'm happy to have both of you there. And I'm like, wait a minute, to be part of, you know, part of the crew, both of y'all. She thought, I'm not, both of y'all is only two people, right? I think both of y'all is only two people. But she said something about, and I wish I had wrote the full thing out, but I'm pretty sure it was about, she was, you know, happy to have both of them on the force. And I'm like, both of them, so Bennett just not, Chocolate Bennett just got caught. I guess he was so chocolate, they couldn't see him and catch him. He says, all of you would have probably been better. But Finola's a great actress, so we know, I don't know. Maybe she ain't grateful for Chocolate Bennett because he don't agree with Dexy. Moving along, Chase welcomes him in, though, and tells him he deserves a few beers after he aced that test. And Dex notes that a couple of guys thinks he does, too, in the back of his head. Dex, really? Is getting back at Sunny really worth this? Why can't you just go be a fireman, go be a firefighter, man? You can be a firefighter. Dex the firefighter, I can believe that. Now I can believe that more than Dex the cop. I could definitely see Dex, you know, as he gets more mature too and fits into his more of his uniform. Ooh, fireman be fine. Moving along, because I'm getting off subject. Finn and Anna catch up. They discuss, you know, Dex and the awkwardness of that, and Finn turning into a pumpkin, which I find hilarious. And I wrote, P.S. I like them, guys. I did. I liked Finn and Anna. I actually like Finn and Anna a million times more than I've liked Finn with anybody. Yeah. I liked Finn and Anna. That was hot. I liked that. They were. I liked their relationship. I did. Yeah, I did. But anyway, so Jordan, we're going to go back to Jordan and Curtis. And they're discussing, you know, resets in life and changing focuses and no longer focusing on certain things, but more like, you know, living life and being, you know, safe. He's thinking about his family now. So I'm thinking when he was talking to Jordan about that, remember when they were supposed to work together to figure out who shot him? Now he's like, I don't want to know. And really, he wanted to know, but Portia said he didn't want to know. So really, he could have let off. Well, Portia says that I can't go out no more and be Superman, and I got to find something to keep my feet on the ground. I think that's what really was going on there. But anyway, Drew comes and, you know, it's like, hey, Jordan, it's your turn. And says it from the X talk. And even though she's never thrown before, she actually sticks it. And I was like, okay, go ahead on, Jordan. I want to try that. My son said it was fun. Drew, of course, congratulates her. And then they discussed, you know, the uncomfortable. Because she's like, and thank you. And thank you for giving me encouragement. And thank you again for saving me. He's like, saving you? She's like, look, you know, I'm happy for him and all that. But that conversation, he was like, oh, yeah, I mean, the ex conversation, the uncomfortableness, the forced smiles. And she's like, I was smiling so hard my face hurt. Because, you know, I want so much better for Jordan than Drew or Curtis. I mean, everybody says they see a little sparkle there. I think it's weird. That's her man's ex-husband's best friend. So that's just weird to me. But anyway. They talk about the moving on and how you're so happy. And it just hurts. I felt Drew when he said that because I think, you know, he was talking about Carly. So now it's gifts opening and they're opening the red sock. I mean, gifts, now it's gift time and Dante got him a red Sox baseball sign. That was pretty cool. And Finn and the family, you know what, guys, I didn't write down what he got. But the little girl picked it out. I was supposed to go back and write it in, but I didn't. I'm sorry. Dex is walking around getting straight shot. He picks up his mirror. He looks at some guys, and he's like, oh, I guess I'll go over there. They're like, ugh. It was like Mean Girls meets the Cop edition, okay? Mean Girls meet the Cop. Doing this, I'm telling you right now, I would not be putting my neck out here and trusting that these guys, because you got to trust that your partner got your six and your nine, but your six too. I mean, you gotta trust, you know what I'm saying? Dex, I don't think this is for you, honey. And I know that one of the sneak peeks was talking about Dex is reconsidering being a cop. I would, yes, I definitely would. I would look into, you know, working at the zoo, you know, as a veterinarian, you know, working with animals, you know, or better yet, working at Christina's place with the kids and the long lost children. Like, you know how he was taking care of Adam, little guy or little dude, whatever he was calling him, something like that, giving back, you know, a firefighter. I could do that, but cop, no, this ain't for you. Chocolate. Chocolate Bennett tells Dex, you must got a death wish, boy, because Sonny Carrithos don't forget. Like, see, I'm just, Dex, baby, the writing's on the wall. Anna ain't thinking about you right now, okay? I honestly, we don't know where Fanola is. She's just been everywhere lately, so I wouldn't do it, Dex. Dante can see and feel the tension in the air, and he's, you know, trying to say, hey, this guy here, you know, he's one of the people that made it me here to be here so I can keep making you guys look bad. Ha ha ha. And they're like, yeah, fuck you. That didn't help. Dex knew it didn't help. Well, thanks for trying. Dante tells him, well, man, if you're gonna be a cop and you're gonna be a hero, you're gonna have to expect that and prepare yourself for it. So I mean, everybody's kind of like, dude, what are you doing? What are you doing? You know what I'm saying? Background, Chase is congratulating Finn, and I think he's congratulating him on his relationship with Liz. We're going to assume that. Ned gives a Father's toast to his son-in-law while he's swinging the axe to the point where Anna's like, I'm going to take that from you so you can finish your toast. Let me see. But welcomes him to the family. Curtis and Dante, of course, follow up with follow-up toast. Anna and Dante talk. She notes that what Dante did for Dex, and Dante questions Dex joining the Force. We are all questioning Dex joining the Force, okay? Anna brings up Dante worrying about Dex giving away intel on Sunny. And Dante's like, dude, really? And it's like, oh yeah, I said that out loud. I was just thinking that, but then I said it out loud. I don't know what I'm doing right now. I'm just kind of I got Pikeman and Valentine on my head. I'm sorry, baby. I'm sorry, okay? but you know what? I don't know if Dante is more concerned about Dex spilling the beans versus his father spilling Dex's beans all over the sidewalk. Okay, I'm sorry. That's not funny, Twerry. Why are you laughing? Because it is. Oh, Jesus. Okay. Finn introduces the other woman in Chase's life, which happens to be Blaze, who delivers a second round and an epic toast to her best buddy, Chase. You know, when they walk together, I almost was like, they are hot together. Chase and Blaze, I almost was like, is that how they're going to swing it for a minute? Because their chemistry was pretty hot between them two. I am not going to front. It was actually very hot between those two. I don't know what it is, but it was pretty good. I don't know. Y'all might not agree with me. Let me know. But anyway, Brooklyn's wedding shower, guys. And I took video, and I'm going to be posting video of some of the dances because I couldn't help myself. Okay, so Brooklyn gives her thank you speech. I'm so happy for Brookie. I am. She is one of my I don't care for her. I don't hate her, and I don't like her. I just, she's kind of just there. I mean, I like her more than I like Liz. Brooke's cool, you know. I'm not gonna say anything, but I'm happy for her, and I think her and Chase gonna make a cute couple. But we got so Brooke's giving her thank you speech. Chris and Blaze is present. They're doing a sober night because you know Blaze wants to. She's driving. I'm just gonna put that out there. She's driving a different party, so she got to stay sober. Tracy asked Lois, where's the music? Lois forgot. And just for a second, how she was being over-exaggerative about, like, do you know people and all that. I thought that was just a joke. I did. I thought that was just a joke. But it wasn't. Because Sasha walks up and says, okay, calm down. Because Lois was starting to offer to sing. And I'm like, okay, she must be joking. And that's when Sasha points out Spinelli. And Lois is like, I hope he ain't the stripper. And I'm like, ooh, there's going to be strippers? What? It's GH strippers. You know, we've seen the strippers. We've all watched the Nurses Ball. Mm-hmm. They have a strip show every time. I don't think they had one last time. I can't remember. Maybe it was so lackluster, that's why. I don't remember. But they normally have some pretty good male strip shows. And, you know, hey, stripper, you know, who knows? Who freaking knows? But anyway, I was, you know, looking for that. So Brooklyn and Willow are talking, and Willow tells Brooklyn that she's happy for them and that they will make it there through together because, you know, there's history between those four. Well, not Michael and Brooklyn. Michael and Brooklyn are cousins, but, you know, Willow and Chase. So she knows he's a good guy. Anyway, Maxie thanks Sasha for saving the day at Home and Heart. Sasha tells her she's always there to help, but she's glad she is not the face of deception anymore. They discuss Blaze, and I'm like, okay, but Blaze hasn't even really did anything, so what's to discuss with that? And Sasha's free time with Cody, because that's exactly what she's doing, and cow poop all day. I mean, cow poop, horse poop, and horse hay and all that, smelling like a barnyard. And Maxie mentions planning another bachelorette party. And Sarshi's like, yeah, because you and Spinelli are going to spin that apple one more time, eh? I was like, good way to throw it right back at her, Sasha. Good way. And that's when DJ Spinelli sets up. He's about to be rocking the kibosh. And I'm like, what in the world is a kibosh? I am. Okay, guys, you know I'm Gen X, 51. That might be a new name. Y'all might know the name. I don't know what kibosh is. And neither does Maxie, because she's like, let me check out that playlist. And he says, what are you talking about? It was good for the bar mitzvah. And she's like, oh, I most definitely gotta check this playlist. And I was happy that she did. And then we're going to move over to Sasha, Willow, and Brooklyn, and they're discussing Maxie Spinelli and Willow. Oh, and you know how they're so hard-headed about each other, and Willow throws a little shade over to Sasha about her and Cody, because, you know, everybody knows. Okay, so the Quartermains, come on. That family, that's all they do. There is no secrets. Only the secrets that they use to destroy each other. But other than that, there is no secrets. So, of course, they know that Sasha's been hanging out at the Quartermain barn with Cody. Oh my goodness. Let's see. Yeah, but Willow throws a little spark back to Sasha when Sasha mentions they can't fight it forever, and neither can she. And I'm like, you're trying to say that you need more time, but you're around this man 24/7. Anyway, Lois gives her mama toast and says, you know, that the family can be a lot. And Tracy chimes in and said, there's no we. And Lois like, no, there's definitely a we in this. And she's not lying, because even though we don't know her family, but we can only imagine. But we know the Quartermains and how they get down. They are definitely a lot. She then offers to show Brooklyn's bravery pictures, which is a good thing that Liv came and snatched the damn microphone from her hands. And talk about let the games begin. And they play a game of passing the bouquet. Tracy ends up winning. Thinks Spinelli has set her up. And threatens that if he ever DJs at another place and she wins again, I don't know what it means, but I'm just going to say, off with your head. And I put still no stripper. Anyway. Blaze, tells Sasha that she's going to be, Blaze and Christina and Tasha are talking about, you know, all things deception, and Blaze is telling her that Sasha's going to be a tough act to follow, and Sasha tells her, girl, just stick with Maxie, you got this, and you know, Blaze is beautiful, so this is going to be interesting. I'm looking forward to it, and now it's picture time, and that was cute. I took videos of that too, guys, I'll be posting that later. And the girls show up. Joss and Trina, the youngins. And Joss goes to get the drinks. Trina's like, damn, she's gone already. Okay, girl, I guess I'll have me a drink. And I'm so glad they got Trina out, man. She needed to dance. She needed to smile. When she was watching Spinelli dance, she was like, okay, I see you. Go ahead. He was feeling himself. It was so cute. Joss almost bumps into Christina. Christina apologizes, and she's like, that's fine. Joss tells her that it was good to see her, and they, you know, part their ways. Christina walks away like, awkward! I'm like, you're awkward. You are awkward. And why is your belly growing bigger every time we see you? First it was a little bump. Now it's a bigger bump. Are they just growing her bump as we're sitting there so we can believe something's going to happen because now the bump is so big? Anyway, Blaze mentioned something about dousing Joss with her drink, and Christina's like, oh, I thought about it, and I'm like, pregnant women always do the most. Girl, your face ain't pregnant. I would have doused you right back. Ah, you doused a pregnant woman. She's dousing me. She obviously wants to get wet back, and I would have splash, splash, splashed her right on back. I sure would have. I would have clapped my hands as Jocelyn is dumping the liquor on her forehead. Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. I'm not saying strike nobody. You know what? That's not violence. But, I mean, girls, they be trying to do the most when they be pregnant. No, when you, girl, you ain't going to be pregnant for long. Only 9 months. Cash me outside. That's not me. I'm just saying. Maybe that was me in the past, but we gonna move forward. I'm just playing, guys. Lois in Brooklyn. Welcome, Trina. And Brooklyn is feeling the Brooklyn chaser. And yeah, you could tell just about everybody is feeling that drink. Okay? Brooklyn definitely was feeling it. Even she could tell because she was slurring. But it was gift time. Oh, and a heart moment is when Lois gave Brooklyn a favorite brooch that Brooklyn used to play with as a child. And guys, that brought me back to a memory of my great-great-granny. She had this drawer full of just like all of this costume necklaces and earrings. And some of it was not costume, just like, you know, Brooklyn said. And it was beautiful. I felt like every time I opened that drawer, it was like looking in a treasure box. And there was some beautiful pieces in there. And I did not treat them properly. I ain't gonna lie, I was a stupid kid. Those were antiques, and that was probably worth a lot of money right now. I'm pretty sure my great-granny is probably rolling in her grave trying to kick my butt for messing up some of that stuff. I'm sorry, Granny. Ah, back to the story. But that touched my heart, brought back a memory. Okay, guys, now it's dance time. Hey, okay, guys, this party was actually crumper than the bachelor party. I mean, this party was going on, okay? So Brooklyn asked Granny to come dance, and she's like, girl, you know I don't dance. So Brooklyn's like, come on, Trina, let's go, girl. And I'm like, you know what? Brooklyn had a little move. You know, when she was walking up to her, she was like, come on. Trina was like, girl, what you doing? But Brooklyn was doing it, you know what I'm saying? She's like, come on, Grandma. Then she was on to the, I don't know what the hell they were listening to, but she was on to the beat of it, you know what I'm saying? And, man, Lois and Olivia's dance moves. I took videos of that too, guys. Posting that later. Blaze heads out to Chase's bachelor party, and Joss asks Tracy out to dance. She's like, girl, come on, we gotta show him how to do it. And tells her that, you know, if Bobby was here, she'd be out here dancing. And Tracy's like, you know what? You're right. And Tracy gets out there and starts cutting it up, shaking her tail. I was like, go, Tracy. Oh, girl. When I tell you Grandma showed up, it was them Brook Chasers. Them things was good. Them things was good, but she was cutting it up. And then Spinelli's windmill dancing. Hey, Trina's like, hey, I see you. He was like, the confidence, you know what I'm saying? Woo! Yeah! I was like, oh, they are turning. And Maxie's looking at him like, oh my God, my baby daddy. And everybody except for sober and now bored Christina, because her girlfriend's gone, walks up. They actually, Chris Joss is at the bar getting her something else to drink. She's trying to turn up. And sober Christina, which is probably if she wasn't pregnant and sober and being who she is right now, would have been a lot more fun, because them two used to be okay with each other. But anyway, she walks up. And she's not looking as she is walking to, because everybody's watching Tracy, because everybody's like, get it, Tracy. And she's walking to the bar, and she's not there, and she almost runs into Jocelyn again. And where was I at? She calls Jocelyn basically a drunk, and then she's dumping her issues on her. And I'm like, wait a second. You approached her. Then started a conversation. Okay, that accident approach might have been an accidental, y'all, right? But then you start a conversation questioning her at her motives towards you. Joss tells her about Dex and the breakup, and Kristen is like, well, he doesn't work for my dad, so I don't even know what you're talking about. And he broke up with your ass because you're so self-righteous. If your self-righteous attitude. And she's like, nope. He broke up because after your daddy nearly beat that man to death, he sent Dex up there to unalive him at the hospital bed. I was like, shut her up! Shut her up! Christina's face was like this. And you know what this brought me to? When Dante had to come to grips about who Sonny was. You know what I'm saying? I remember that. I remember that. I remember when all the kids had to come to grips. I think the only person, who Michael, was, he kind of like, I want to be like my dad. And Morgan, yeah. They were the only two until Michael was like, I went to jail. I want to be like my dad no more. But, yeah, that was, I said, well, I guess she had to shut her up some way. And now, if this drives this girl into early labor, I'm going to be done. I'm going to be done with everything, okay? Anyway, meanwhile, Trina having a good old time, and she's taking selfies with Willow, and Willow like, girl, who you sending these selfies to? She's, grandma, Stella. I can't send them to Spencer. He ain't on here yet. But that is the end of that show. And yes, guys, I spent 30 minutes talking about a bachelorette party and a bachelor party. But we had fun, didn't we? Please hit that like and subscribe. And I hope you guys have an amazing night. Sleep well tonight. Have an amazing day tomorrow. Thank you so much for all your subscription. God bless, and I will talk to you soon. Mwah!